Selamat pagi, saudara-saudari dalam Kristus. Selamat datang ke Misa Pentabisan Episkopal ini untuk Right Reverend Simon Peter Poh sebagai Uskup Auxiliary Kuching. Sekarang marilah kita memulakan sambutan Ekaristi dengan pujian dan syukur sambil menyanyikan lagu Priestly People yang boleh didapati di muka surat 2 pada buku kecil yang telah diedarkan.
主内的兄弟姐妹，大家早上好！欢迎大家来参加西满伯多副营生后任主教、静穆维古静总教区弗里主教的弥撒圣祭。我们的敬堂咏是在弥撒礼仪手册的第二面 ，Priestly People。
Good morning, sisters and brothers in Christ. Welcome to this Episcopal Ordination Mass for Right Reverend Simon Peter Poh Hun Seng as Auxiliary Bishop of Kuching. Let us now enter into this Eucharistic celebration with joyous praise by singing the entrance hymn, Priestly People, found on page 2 of the booklet. Please stand.
Thank you. Good morning, sisters and brothers in the Lord. Before we begin the Episcopal Ordination Mass, I humbly request you for a few minutes to gratefully acknowledge, on behalf of Archbishop Emeritus, the clergy, religious and faithful of the Archdiocese of Kuching, the gracious presence of His Grace, Archbishop Joseph Marino, Apostolic Nuncio to Malaysia. His Grace, Archbishop Julian Liao, Archbishop of Kuala Lumpur. His Grace, Archbishop John Wong, Archbishop of Kota Kinabalu. His Grace, Archbishop William Goh, Archbishop of Singapore. His Lordship, Bishop Paul Tan, Bishop of Malacca, Johor. His Lordship, Bishop Sebastian Francis, Bishop of Penang. His Lordship, Bishop Cornelius Byong, Bishop of Keningau. His Lordship, Bishop Julius Dusin, Bishop of Sandakan. His Lordship, Bishop Joseph He, Bishop of Cebu. His Lordship, Bishop Richard Ng, Bishop of Miri. His Lordship, Bishop Cornelius Sim, Vicar Apostolic of Brunei. His Lordship, Bishop Silvio Siripong, Bishop of Chantaburi, Thailand. His Grace, Archbishop Emeritus Murphy Pakiam. His Lordship, Bishop Emeritus James Chan. His Lordship, Bishop Anthony Selvanayagam. He is the Emeritus of Penang. His Lordship, Bishop Emeritus Dominic Su. His Lordship, Bishop Emeritus Lawrence Tien Chai of Chantaburi, Thailand. Also the heads of churches who are present, Reverend Chin Sai Hui, representing the Methodist Sarawak Chinese Annual Conference. Pastor Lawrence Bani, President of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, Sarawak. Bishop Emeritus, Reverend Hua Yung of the Methodist Church. Dr. Harry Pudun from the SIB Church. And now the Yang Berhormat, Yang Berbahagia, and state dignitaries, current as well as retired. YB Dato Sri Michael Manyin and Datin Sri Mary. Yang Berbahagia, Tan Sri Leo Mogi. Yang Berbahagia, Tan Sri Celestine Ujang and Puan Sri Elizabeth. Yang Berhormat, Datu Joseph Salang and Datin Lucy Horn. Yang berbahagia, Dato' Ose Murang and Datin Valerie. Yang Arif, Dato' Jesse Fong and Datin Annie. Yang berbahagia, Dato' Aiden Wing and Datin Mariani. Yang berbahagia, Datuk Stephen Timothy Wan Ulok and Datin Bridget. Yang berbahagia, Temenggong Austin Dimin and Puan Nelly Sapin. Yang berbahagia, Datuk James Chan and wife. And now, heads of religions in Sarawak. Dr. John Foster of the Baha'i Faith in Sarawak. Mr. Chua Beng Tian, Mr. Yap Ming Kong, and Mr. Pang Ki Han, representing the Kuching Buddhist Society. Mr. Balachandran and Mr. Arumugam, representing the Hindu Sangam. And also the provincials of religious congregations in Malaysia, priests, deacons, religious, and guests from outside the Archdiocese of Kuching. Thank you very much for coming to support the Archdiocese of Kuching as we gather to thank God for his gift to us of an auxiliary bishop in the person of the Right Reverend Simon Poh. And so we are gathered here in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, God has been very kind to us to grant us an auxiliary bishop to help us to continue to grow as the local church in the Archdiocese of Kuching. We are here to thank God for the great gift and to celebrate the ordination of the new bishop. Let us now prepare ourselves for this celebration by calling to mind our sins and turning to the Lord for his forgiveness. Together we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Christ. to God in the highest.
And on earth peace to meet the love of will. We bless you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray. O God, eternal shepherd, who, governing your flock with watchful care, choose to join Simon Poh, your servant and priest, to the College of Bishops this day. Grant, we pray, that by his holiness of life, he may everywhere prove to be a true witness to Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
公读伊撒伊亚先知书。吾主上主的神已经降临在我身上，因为上主给我赋了油，派遣我向众人传报喜信，治疗破碎的心灵，向俘虏宣告自由，释放监狱中的 囚徒，上主要我宣布，这是他所广赐慈爱的禧年，并揭示他向我们报复仇恨的日子。他要我安慰所有忧苦的人，在西庸悲哀的人，一项冠冕，以代替 灰尘铺上喜乐的油，以代替丧服，穿上清洁的服装，以代替沮丧的心神。天主的圣言。 I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. Sing forever of your love. I will sing forever of your love, O Lord. I will sing. Servant, and with my holy oil anointed him. My hand shall always be with him, and my arm shall make him strong. I will sing forever. My love shall be with him, by my name his mind shall be exalted. He will say to me, you are my Father, my God, the rock who saves me. I will sing forever.
Pembacaan dari surat pertama Rasul Petrus. Saudara-saudara yang terkasih, sebagai pemimpin jemaat sendiri dan saksi penderitaan Kristus yang juga akan mendapat bahagian dalam kemuliaan yang akan dinyatakan kelak, aku menasihati para pemimpin jemaat di antara kamu. Gembalakanlah kawanan domba Allah yang ada padamu. Jangan dengan terpaksa, tetapi dengan sukarela, sesuai dengan kehendak Allah. Dan jangan karena mahu mencari keuntungan, tetapi dengan pengabdian diri. Janganlah kamu berbuat seolah-olah kamu mahu memerintah atas mereka yang dipercayakan kepadamu. Tetapi, hendaklah kamu menjadi teladan bagi kawanan domba itu. Maka, apabila gembala agung datang, kamu akan menerima mahkota kemuliaan yang tidak akan layu. Demikian jugalah kamu, hai orang-orang muda, tunduklah kepada pemimpin jemaah, dan kamu semua rendahkanlah dirimu seorang terhadap yang lain. Sebab Allah menentang orang yang sombong, tetapi mengasihani orang yang rendah hati. Karena itu, rendahkanlah dirimu di bawah tangan Allah yang kuat, supaya pada waktunya kamu ditinggikan olehnya. Serahkanlah segala kekhawatiranmu kepadanya, sebab dialah yang memelihara kamu. Sedarlah dan berjaga-jagalah, lawanmu si iblis berjalan keliling, sama seperti singa yang mengaum-ngaum dan mencari orang yang dapat ditelannya. Lawanlah dia dengan iman yang teguh, sebab kamu tahu bahwa semua saudaramu di seluruh dunia menanggung penderitaan yang sama. Dan Allah, sumber segala limpah kurnia, yang telah memanggil kamu dalam Kristus kepada kemuliaannya yang kekal, akan melengkapi, meneguhkan, menguatkan, dan mengukuhkan kamu sesudah kamu menderita seketika lamanya. Dialah yang empunya kuasa sampai selama-lamanya. Amin. Sabda Tuhan.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. After the meal, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these others do?" He answered, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." A second time, he said to him, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" He replied, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you." Jesus said to him, "Look after my sheep." Then he said to him a third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter was upset that he asked him the third time, "Do you love me?" And said, "Lord, you know everything. You know I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep." The Gospel of the Lord.
Most Reverend Father, the Holy Catholic Church, our Mother, asks you to ordain this priest, Simon Poh Hun Seng, to the office of bishop.
Have you a mandate from the Apostolic See?
We have.
Let it be read.
Francis, Bishop, Servant of the Servants of God. To the beloved son, Simon Poh Hun Seng, appointed from the clergy of the Metropolitan See of Kuching to be auxiliary of the same archdiocese, and at the same time chosen to be titular bishop of Sphasphoria, greetings and apostolic benediction. It is a duty of the Roman Pontiff, successor of Peter, to pay attention to the needs of every diocese and its pastors, accepting the request made by the Venerable Brother John Ha Tiong Hok, Archbishop of the Metropolitan See of Kuching, for an auxiliary bishop in order to provide better pastoral care of his faithful. We appoint you, beloved son, for the office. Informed of your qualities and skills in pastoral spiritual care, we deem you suitable for the office and entrust you with it. With the recommendation of the Congregation for the Evangelization of Peoples and by our apostolic authority, we appoint you auxiliary bishop of Kuching and at the same time name you titular bishop of Sphasphoria, with all rights and obligations of the episcopal rank, as well as such duties that it may require of you. We allow you to be ordained by any Catholic bishop of your choice outside the city of Rome, in accordance with the liturgical rites. Before your ordination, you are to make a profession of the Catholic faith, an oath of fidelity to us and our successors as prescribed by the Codex of Canon Law. Finally, beloved son, make sure that you carry out well the office entrusted to you in fraternal communion with the Shepherd of Kuching, drawn by the love of Christ, which is the highest of all virtues, given by the Holy Spirit at the intercession of the Virgin Mother, to sustain you and give you joy continuously. Given at St. Peter in Rome on the 9th day of July in the 2015 year of the Lord and the third year of our pontificate.
saudara dan saudari terkasih dalam Kristus. Sebentar lagi, saudara kita, Father Simon, akan ditabiskan sebagai uskup pembantu untuk melayani gereja tempatan di Keuskupan Agung Kuching. Dalam jawatan ini, beliau adalah di antara pewaris-pewaris atau pengganti-pengganti para rasul yang Tuhan kita, Yesus Kristus, melantik dan mengutus ke seluruh dunia agar meneruskan kerja penyelamatannya, yaitu menjadikan semua bangsa pengikut-pengikutnya, membaptis mereka demi nama Bapa, Putra, dan Roh Kudus, dan mengajar mereka mentaati segala perintahnya. Para rasul serta pewaris-pewaris mereka menjadi gembala-gembala kepada sesiapa yang mereka telah menarik kepada Tuhan Yesus dan menjadi pengikutnya. Kristus, gembala baik, menyuruh mereka, peliharalah anak-anak dombaku, peliharalah domba-dombaku. Untuk menguasakan para rasulnya menjalankan misi mereka ini, Kristus memenuhi hati mereka dengan Roh Kudus. Oleh yang demikian, mereka pergi dengan kuasa Roh Kudus, mewartakan kabar gembira, dan menarik orang-orang memasuki gereja. Suatu kaum yang berasal daripada Allah Trinitas dan adalah serupa dengannya. Dengan kuasa memasuki kaum ini, dengan kuasa Roh Kudus lagi, mereka memelihara segala orang yang memasuki kaum ini sebagai satu kawanan dengan satu gembala, yaitu Kristus. Para rasul Yesus Kristus dikuasai oleh Roh Kudus menurunkan jawatan gembala mereka kepada pewaris-pewaris mereka, yaitu uskup-uskup yang mengganti mereka. Jawatan ini adalah memimpin, menguduskan, dan mengajar pengikut-pengikut Yesus Kristus. Jawatan gembala ini adalah diturunkan melalui penumpangan tangan dari generasi ke generasi sehingga zaman kita dan juga zaman-zaman yang akan datang. Oleh yang demikian, kerja Tuhan Yesus masih berterusan dan berkembang. Injil penyelamatan terus diwartakan dalam dunia kita agar menjadikan lebih banyak pengikut Kristus. Sesungguhnya, melalui jawatan uskup yang dikuasai oleh Roh Kudus, tradisi yang diturunkan dari zaman para rasul Kristus dipelihara dari generasi ke generasi. Dengan yang demikian, kerja Kristus berterusan dan berkembang pada zaman kita juga. Seorang uskup tidak dapat bekerja kecuali dengan padri-padri yang ditabiskan untuk bekerjasama dengannya. Di bawah pimpinan uskup, padri-padri melayani umat-umat Kristen yang diamanahkan kepada mereka dan juga melibatkan umat-umat itu agar mereka pun memainkan peranan mereka dalam gereja penyelamatan Kristus. Hari ini kita menerima dengan sukacita saudara kita, Father Simon, sebagai uskup pembantu bagi kita. Uskup-uskup yang hadir akan menumpang tangan atas beliau untuk mentabis beliau sebagai seorang uskup dan menerima beliau masuk College Uskup-Uskup. Marilah kita menjamin, menyokong beliau dan memasti beliau bahwa kita akan sudi bekerjasama dengan beliau untuk mewartakan Injil penyelamatan dan membina kerajaan Allah di bumi, khasnya di Keuskupan Agung Kuching. Simon Shen Fu 将要被祝圣为主教，成为古晋总教区的福利主教。身为主教，他也就是中途门的一位承继承人。耶稣拣选了中途门来继续他拯救人类的工作，派遣他们出去， 使万民成为门徒，应付基督之圣神之名给他们受洗，然后如同牧人一样的侍奉他们，就如基督好牧人给予宗徒们的命令：喂养我的羔羊，牧放我的羊群。 为了要授权给宗徒们来执行这个使命，耶稣派遣了圣神来到他们当中，使他们勇敢地出去传播福音，并且吸引众人加入由天主圣山所建立的教会。宗徒们 也同样的借着圣神来看护和牧放门徒们，使他们成为基督好牧人的羊群。圣神所授权给宗徒们的牧放、圣化和训导的职务，借着父手礼 得以传下给他们的继承人，也就是主教们。这些继承人也同样的把他们的职务一代一代的传下去，直到现代。因此，耶稣拯救人类的工作能够不停的扩展， 让更多的人能够听到了福音，并决定成为基督徒。的确，主教最基本的职务就是实行耶稣给宗徒们的使命，继续扩展他拯救人类的工作。 没有一位主教能够单独的实行这个使命。每一位主教都需要司铎的合作。有司铎们的合作，主教们才能带领平信徒们一起做他们的本分，来参与基督拯救人类的工作。 在此，让我们欢喜地欢迎我们的弟兄 Simon 神父，借着主教们给他的副手，成为主教及主教团的一位成员。我们也全心全意地接受他为
福音，并保证给予他支持及合作，好让我们一起来传播福音，在古晋总教区建立天主的国。
And now, dear Brother Simon, the Lord has chosen you from among our priests and appointed you for the office of bishop. As you well know, this office is one of service, not of honor. Its exercise requires a heart of humility and readiness to serve. It is admirable and comforting that you have chosen shepherd after the heart of Christ as your episcopal motto. By it, you affirm your desire to serve as Christ the shepherd has served, to the point of laying down his life for his sheep. We therefore take it that you will spare no effort to preach the word in season and out of season, to pray and offer sacrifice for the people committed to your care, and to devote yourself wholeheartedly to seeking every kind of grace for them from the fullness of Christ's holiness. In exercising pastoral care of Christ's flock and drawing more people to it, you will always be mindful of Christ, the Good Shepherd. He knows his sheep, and they know him. Where and when you feel overburdened, unload all your worries onto him, since he is looking after you, as St. Peter advises in the second reading. I personally look forward to your continued assistance in the exercise of my episcopal ministry. I have been enjoying your close and generous cooperation ever since I took over as Archbishop of Kuching in 2003. For this, I am grateful to you. Now, as bishop, you share my ministry even more closely and fully. Ours is not pastoral ministry in a given area or parish, but a diocese. Together, therefore, we will incessantly pursue the vision the Archdiocese and Pastoral Council set for the Archdiocese at the Archdiocesan Pastoral Congress in 2012. Church, disciples of the word in communion formation. We will encourage and lead through our own commitment our collaborators, the priests, to pursue the vision. We know from experience how committed our lay leaders are to this cause. Let us inspire and motivate our priests to give these lay leaders full support so that the faithful in the Archdiocese of Kuching will truly be one flock and one shepherd. Finally, let me affirm that by our laying on of hands on you in the power of the Holy Spirit, that the office of bishop is bestowed on you, and you are joined to the College of Bishops in the Catholic Church. By virtue of this, your care and concerns should be for all churches, especially those in need. Render your support for them to the best of your ability, and so keep watch over the whole flock, not simply as a duty, but
gladly. God appoints you to govern this flock, his church, in the name of the Father, whose image you represent in the church, in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, whose office of teacher, priest, and shepherd you will discharge, and in the name of the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the Church of Christ, and by his power strengthens us in our weakness. My brother Simon, the ancient rule of the Holy Fathers ordains that a bishop-elect is to be questioned in the presence of the people on his resolve to uphold the faith and to discharge his duty. And so, I ask, do you resolve by the grace of the Holy Spirit to discharge until death the office entrusted to us by the apostles, which we are about to pass on to you by the laying on of our hands?
I do.
Do you resolve to preach the gospel of Christ with constancy and fidelity?
I do.
Do you resolve to guard the deposit of faith entire and incorrupt, as handed down by the apostles and preserved in the church everywhere and at all times?
I do.
Do you resolve to build up the body of Christ, his church, and to remain in the unity of that body together with the order of bishops under the authority of the successor of St. Peter the Apostle?
I do.
Do you resolve to render obedience faithfully to the successor of the blessed apostle Peter?
I do.
Do you resolve to guide the holy people of God in the way of salvation as a devoted father and sustain them with the help of your fellow ministers, the priests and deacons?
I do.
Do you resolve for the sake of the Lord's name to be welcoming and merciful to the poor, to strangers, and to all who are in need?
I do.
Do you resolve as a good shepherd to seek out the sheep and stray, the sheep who stray, and gather them into the Lord's fold?
I do.
Do you resolve to pray without ceasing to Almighty God for the holy people and to carry out the office of high priest without reproach?
I do, with the help of God.
May God, who has begun the good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. Dearly beloved, let us pray that the kindness of Almighty God in providing for the welfare of the Church will yield an abundance of His grace for His chosen one.
Let us kneel.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Mary, Mother of God, Saint Michael, holy angels of God, Saint John the Baptist, Saint Joseph, Saint Peter and Saint Paul, Saint Andrew and Saint James, Saint John.
Companions, all holy men
saints of God. Together in peace and true harmony. Comfort with your mercy the troubled and the afflicted. Strengthen all of us and keep us in your holy service. Jesus, Son of the living God.
Graciously hear our petitions, O Lord, and pour out upon this your servant the power of your blessing, flowing from the horn of priestly grace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Let us stand.
God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father of mercies and God of all consolation, who dwell on high and look upon the lowly, who know all things before they come to be, and who laid down observances in your church through the word of your grace, who from the beginning foreordained a nation of the just, born of Abraham, who established rulers and priests, and did not leave your sanctuary without ministers, and who, from the foundation of the world, were pleased to be glorified in those you have chosen. Pour out now upon this chosen one that power which is from you, the spirit of governance, whom you gave to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, the spirit whom he bestowed upon the holy apostles, who established the church in each place as the sanctuary for the glory and unceasing praise of your name. Grant, O Father, knower of all hearts, that this your servant, whom you have chosen for the office of bishop, may shepherd your holy flock. Serving you night and day, may he fulfill before you without reproach the ministry of the high priesthood, so that, always gaining your favor, he may offer up the gifts of your holy church. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of the High Priesthood, he may have the power to forgive sins according to your command, assign offices according to your decree, and loose every bond according to the power given by you to the apostles. May he please you by his meekness and purity of heart, presenting a fragrant offering to you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through whom glory and power and honor are yours, with the Holy Spirit in the Holy Church, now and forever. May God, who has made you a sharer of the high priesthood of Christ, himself pour out upon you the oil of mystical anointing and make you fruitful with an abundance of spiritual blessings. Receive the gospel and preach the word of God with all patience and sound teaching. Receive this ring, the seal of fidelity, adorned with undefiled faith, preserve unblemished the bride of God, the Holy Church. Receive the mitre, and may the splendor of holiness shine forth in you, so that when the chief shepherd appears, you may deserve to receive from him an unfading crown of glory. Receive the crozier, the sign of your pastoral office, and keep watch over the whole flock in which the Holy Spirit has placed you as bishop to govern the Church of God.
Thank you.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this oblation, O Lord, which we have presented for your church and for Simon, your servant and bishop, become an offering acceptable to you, and for the good of the flock, may he whom you have raised up among your people to be high priest be endowed by your gift with apostolic virtues, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son high priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design were pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Holy.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father, most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, On the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
And profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
Lord, renew your church by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the body of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people. Together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and this your servant Simon, whom today you have been pleased to choose for the service of your people, and the whole order of bishops, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. Thou, In communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Christ, Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Let us pray. By the power of this sacrament, O Lord, increase the gifts of your grace in Simon, your servant and bishop, that he may serve you worthily in the pastoral ministry and receive the eternal rewards of a faithful steward, through Christ our Lord.
Gloria numerari, salvum fac.
We now kindly invite His Grace, Archbishop Joseph Salvador Marino, the Apostolic Nuncio to Malaysia, to kindly give his address.
It is a great joy for me as representative of Pope Francis to Malaysia to be present today celebrating with the church in Kuching the ordination of its auxiliary bishop, His Excellency Simon Poh. The rich ordination ceremony, which we have just witnessed and celebrated, places into focus one of the essential characteristics of the church, namely communion. That is the union that exists within the church founded by our Lord Jesus Christ. Indeed, we heard the words of the bull of Pope Francis, who alone appoints bishops in the church, and who authorized this ordination to take place today. The other bishops present represent the essential ecclesial communion of all the bishops in the world, forming the College of Bishops, whose head is the Bishop of the Roman Church, the Vicar of Christ, the Pastor of the Universal Church, our Holy Father, Pope Francis. Dear Bishop Simon, your entrance into the College of Bishops today requires of you great responsibility. In fact, before us today, you promised that you would build up the body of Christ, the Church, in union with our Holy Father and in strict collaboration with Archbishop Ha. Your membership into the Cardinal of Bishops also brings about immediate pastoral consequences, because not only will you carry out your ministry in working with Archbishop Ha for the good of the church in Kuching, but you also have a responsibility to show care and solicitude and attention to the other churches throughout the world, especially the ones that are suffering and need of support and care. And we know that there are many. Bishop Simon, with all the members of the church in Kuching, with your family and friends, I extend to you sincerest best wishes as you undertake this ministry of service entrusted to you today by our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the chief shepherd of the church. As Pope Francis told the bishops in Ecuador a few months ago in July when he was there, we are to become perfect, like the great shepherd of the sheep. This means that we are to be conformed to Jesus Christ, who in his earthly life, with prayers and supplications, with loud cries and tears, achieved perfection when, through suffering, he learned the meaning of obedience. Be assured of our prayers that the Holy Spirit will guide you in all your steps so that the church in Kuching will grow ever more boldly and visibly in its faith and in its proclamation in life of our communion with the one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Congratulations, Bishop.
And now, we'd like to invite His Lordship, Bishop Simon Poh, to say a few words.
First of all, I wish peace be with you.
brothers and sisters in the Lord and friends who are coming here, our first and foremost glory and honor we give to our God. It is God who has not just called me, called all of us here. He gathered us as a priestly people, a holy people, gathered here together as one family, a prophetic people. He gathered us here as a church. And I'm humbled today coming before here amidst you as a servant of this church. First, I would like to, on behalf of the Archdiocese of Kuching, we have heard our Apostolic Nuncio, who represents the Holy Father, I would like to convey my loyalty, and also I believe all of us here, our loyalty to the Holy Father, and we ask our Nuncio, Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Joseph Marino, to convey to the Holy Father. I think our support can be a bit louder than that, can it not be?
Yeah.
As you can see, I am very tense because this is live broadcast, so I forgot those out there who are watching, who are joining us from far. I also wish you the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ. I know that I'm here not by my own self. Yesterday in the newspaper, it was published from an altar boy to a bishop. But it is more than that. It was much earlier. I have first to be baptized. And when I look back in my life journey, it is God who has prepared the way. And there are many people who have passed on that faith, the Catholic faith, to me until I was baptized in Form 4. So for all those people who have accompanied, journeyed me, and especially my family, Mom, Joseph, my mom, Geraldine, Daddy Joseph, and then my sister after me, Irene, then Doreen, Raymond, and Norman, five of us, we were baptized around this time when we became Catholic as a family. And so today, as I stand before you, I do not stand alone. I stand as a gift of my family to the church, but it is more than my family. When I became a priest, it was a gift of God for me as a priest to the whole community. And today, as I stand before you as a bishop, it is not about me, it is more about the church gathered here, very beautifully put. Our vision mission for the Archdiocese is the church, disciples of the word in communion for mission. Today we are celebrating our communion. We are one, not just among our own dioceses or parishes. We have bishops from all over, from Thailand, as far as Thailand, and throughout Malaysia, Brunei, Singapore, and representing our Holy Father, Archbishop Joseph Marino. We are one community. And in this journey of accompaniment, it is very a blessing for me to have all of you, and I remember all the brother priests here, my classmates who are here, all of us were eight of us now or then, and they were here to support me. And it has been a great joy to be able to be here, and so I invite all of us to focus again on this celebration, to celebrate God's steadfast love and mercy. And as a community here, I know we've been using English a lot, but allow me just to address a few words in other languages. 亲爱兄弟姐妹们，刚才我问主教，我要做的责任是在我已经在英文写在那边 ，Shepherd of the Heart of Jesus.
讲主教翻译成中文，所以主教帮忙我翻译。属于这基督心的牧人，所以我要求你们为我祈祷，祝福我，让我能够做好好的牧人，按照耶稣的心为你们服务。所以我表谢谢你们能够来到这边今天支持我们，在这边或是在SMS、Facebook上面、Messenger等等的有支持我。 Kepada saudara seiman yang datang dari jauh, yang saya tahu ini adalah gereja kita yang berkumpul di sini di Archdiocese Kuching ini, datang dari jauh dan dekat. Di paroki memang di pasar memang semua senang untuk datang ke sini, dari St. Joseph Cathedral termasuk St. Mark Kamalai dan juga St. Peter's Church Padungan, yang juga tidak terlupa Our Lady Star di Bintawa, dan juga community dari Blessed Sacrament Church, Holy Trinity Church, Chapel of Mother Mary, dan Batu Tujuh, Kota Sentosa, dan luar daripada itu. So ingan so patus mong, angan aku ingin terima kasih, angan lagi nok titi, gas so aku, nyukong aku, pak rubi lagi, atau atak dikuruk dikiti, isa itepak berkat so perkta, sa gereja tak, makin berkembang saat tak pikirin pengirindu damai tepat. From St. Anne's Parish, where I've served for 4 years, may God bless your community under the leadership of the priest also present here. Ingan so bau, dah ku komut sinah bau, walaupun masa seminarian aku mau belajar, bogo aku suka dang sina bi bau kam eklesia tok tok onuiti otok jadi kam eklesia ni buah gereja dari lunduk. Terima kasih, and we have also the priest here, of course, representing us, supporting me from lunduk all the way masuk Sirian Bunan Tebedu. Terima kasih aku kuan johok ka angan bala memendek titik jadi bala gende masuk Bunan Tebedu Parish, Saint Teresa Syrian. Aku juga terima kasih, ahi terima kasih. From my hometown, it's a very, very small town called Semanggang, where I was born. There are some of you here. So I thank you for coming all the way. It's not so much about me, but it is we want to give thanks to God and ngagai kita keban belayan dalam Yesus Kristus, menyadek dalam Yesus Kristus. Terima kasih yang ngagai nuan semua bisi datai itu hari itu kita beri manjong. Terima kasih ngagai latala. There are still many things in my heart I want to share, but I'd like to acknowledge especially the priests who have come all the way from Thailand. We visited them just a few weeks before I, just 2 weeks before I, before today, and they have actually come in here to be with me, and not just the priest, the Bishop of the Diocese of Canterbury, Bishop Silvo, and Bishop Emeritus Tian Chai, Lawrence Tian Chai. Bishop James and Tian Chai are very good friends, so Bishop James Sun is from Johor Bahru. And the priests are here. You just stand up, we can see you, because there are so many of them who just flew in. The Thai priests and all my brother priests, okay, all the brother priests here who came from Taiwan, etc. So I'm very touched and humbled by you. There are still so many things, but I think I will put a reflection. You've already seen the reflection in the magazine. So what I do is I just use the closing words for you. And I would like to thank my parents, Joseph and Geraldine, for their faith, and my siblings here, Doreen, Raymond, Norman, Irene, and their respective families for the support. In 1982, when I said yes to enter the seminary, Right to the day of my ordination in 1988, it was a very difficult time for our family. I am the eldest son, but my family had willingly offered me to God as his priest. While they struggled to make ends meet, we had to walk in faith then. At that time, in a funny way of looking, I remember when I entered the seminary, many people said, "Now, cannot get married." Now, oleh kahwin, nadai kahwin. Dia tahu besi ya, besi cincin besar dia tahu. I have a big ring today. The ring stands for I'm married. You don't believe me? I'm married to the church. As at pre-marriage course, I will say, I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad times, in sickness and in health, to love and honor the church all the days of my life. Anyway, today, as my family comes together after 27 years, today on this ordination day, our family stand humbly before you. I invite, maybe you can stand, Pa, Ma, Raymond, Irene, Doreen, Norman. Okay. These are the five little brothers and sisters with my parents. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, five. I'm the fifth one here. Yeah. I was counting five. Okay. This month, we stand humbly before you as a testimony of the Lord's faithfulness and mercy. The Lord has guided and provided for us through those challenging years. Once again, my family will gather. We'll today gather before the Lord's altar to give thanks to God. And with you, they have presented me to God for consecration as his humble servant bishop. And so I assure you, parents, give your children to God. There will be blessing. Give thanks to our Heavenly Father, who is exceedingly more generous, for his blessing is 100-fold. So to conclude, I just pray that this ordination may be a celebration. It is a celebration of God's love and mercy for the Archdiocese. For us, from Pentecost Sunday this year until May, Pentecost Sunday next year, we are in the midst of a one-year preparation for the 40th anniversary of the Archdiocese and the Catholic Church in East Malaysia in communion, in solidarity with the dioceses of Miri, Kota Kinabalu has now two other dioceses, Sandakan and Keningau, and in Kuching here, and we have a new diocese born from Kuching in Cebu. But 40 years ago, next year, we became the three dioceses, and I hasten to include Brunei was part of Miri Diocese. So basically, we are in the midst of a 40-year of celebration preparation for the 40th anniversary of the church in East Malaysia. Next year will be our anniversary. And so this communion, this solidarity, we pray, we have taken the theme, may this ordination today not be just about myself, it's bigger than me. It is a worldwide church, but for the church in East Malaysia, may it rightfully be our thanksgiving to God as we celebrate our communion as church, celebrating God's steadfast love and mercy. Glory to God, who is able to do far more than we can could ask or imagine by his power work at work in us. Glory to our God in the church and in Christ Jesus for all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May the Lord bless and keep you, and as he has willed to set you as high priest over his people, so may he make you happy in this present life and grant you a share in the happiness that is eternal. May he grant that the clergy and people he has chosen to unite by his gracious help be happily governed by his providence and your stewardship for many years to come.
Amen.
May they obey God's commandments free from adversity, and may they abound in all that is good, submitting in faith to your ministry, so that they may enjoy peace and tranquility in the present age, and with you be found worthy to share the company of the citizens of eternity.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Before we leave, I forgot to add a last bit of a thank you acknowledgement. I want to thank the team that has worked really, really hard these last few months. We knew the news 3 months ago, the Secretariat, Transport, Logistics, Liturgy, the support from the Sisters of St. Francis of Sarawak, Accommodation and Hospitality Team, First Aid Team, Rela, Sound and Lighting, Ladies Guild of all the whole Archdiocese, the Welcoming Team, the Choices, KYCS, Alumni Kaya, Wardens from all over the parishes, Altar Service, Choirs, the lay groups and many volunteers, and in particular, the stadium management. The stadium was due for renovation and all bookings were canceled. We requested and they accepted to move the renovation back by a month so that we can have this blessed. And indeed, rightfully so, this is called Stadium Perpaduan, Harmony Stadium, that we are gathered here with head of churches of other Christian churches with other faith and as a community, and indeed. So we want to thank God for everything, and in a particular way, this committee comes under the leadership of Father Nicholas Ng in particular, who has journeyed and worked very hard. Father Nicholas Ng is very quiet, but thank you very much, Father. And gathered in this Perpaduan, and there are many other people names that I may have left out, those who have supported in one way or another. There are so many, and if I do miss you out, it's not intentional, but the Lord will reward you, and that you are in our prayers. And lastly, in this Stadium Perpaduan, this is a beginning where we can build our nation and our state Sarawak. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to all people of goodwill. May this be a beginning. Thank you for all those who have helped. Let's give them a round of applause for all those who have contributed, and God bless you all.
Ini ada satu pengumuman dari pihak kami untuk tetamu-tetamu yang bersedia untuk pengangkutan. Anda akan melihat tanda ini di luar stadium. Itu bermakna pengangkutan telah tersedia untuk anda semua. Terima kasih.
So, brothers and sisters, for those who need transport for guests, please kindly look for the personnel who will be carrying this placard, Transport for Guests. Thank you.
feel their heart.